Welcome to Ginger Media TV. This is a TV channel where we explore the truth behind the headlines. Today, let us actually look at the picture we've seen going round. Twitter has been agog. It's been trending where it is said that the Imo State Governor, Emeka Ihedioha, was seen giving vehicles to the police. And these vehicles are imported from America. Some have argued that they were bought from Costaris in Lagos. But why Ingenji Media Channel want to look into this is because this is something that has to do with the Igbo nation. The question that Ingenji Media Channel has for Emeka Ihedioha is, why is it that we have Innoson and the Newi that is less than 65 kilometers from Owerri to Newi, and you cannot buy these trucks, these police vehicles from Anambra, a state that you share a boundary with, and a state that is within the Igbo nation? We found it really, really curious that states like Kogi, the Federal Road Safety Commission, the federal government of Nigeria, even the Nigerian military, Innoson builds military trucks for them, which they use battling Boko Haram. There are some part of the parts. There are some parts that they actually specifically do for the Nigerian military to repair some aircraft. Now, all these things Innoson is doing, and obviously, Innoson is equally cheaper because it's produced locally. What Ingenji Media found so curious is, why wouldn't Emeka Ihedioha buy from your brother, buy from a factory that is less than 65 kilometers away? Take this money that you collect from the Southeast, use this money to create create a job within the Southeast. If you are going to, no one is going to do our things for us. You see, we keep saying, Biafra, Biafra, Biafra. This is not how you can run a nation. We must, as a people, begin to love ourselves, patronize ourselves. Many of us and many of the staffs at Ingenji Media, what we do is, if we want to have our senators down, we go to Aba. Honestly, the best materials are in Aba, the best tellers are in Aba, or maybe Bayelsa, as the case may be. But in this case, that someone, you collect money from the people of Ndimo, from Igbo people, from the people of the Southeast, from the Igbo nation, then you spend that money or you send that money to America to nourish the American market, grow their economy, and import that. The only logical thing that Ingenji Media is thinking, why any sensible person would do this, is if there is kickbacks involved. Honestly, that is only when we have kickbacks that one can try to understand what is happening here. It makes absolutely no sense. During the time of former Anambra State Governor, remember, Peter Obi bought over 1,000 vehicles from Innoson. And that was in 2013, 2014, right? 12, 13, 14. Those vehicles bought for all the Igwes, those SUVs, I think then was about 3.5 or 3.8 million. Now, those 17-seater buses bought, for the schools then, those Hilux trucks called Innoson Granite, I think, that was bought for the Anambra State Vigilante Group, over 350 of them that was bought. They are still intact. They are still rugged. They are still being used today. The parts are there locally. If anything happens, you can go to Innoson. Innoson can get you the parts. So why honestly, we at Injinji Media do not understand the reasoning behind this. We would actually want the state governor to come out and douse the tension that is happening. We have seen online that people are beginning to say, if Ihedioha doesn't take care, the threat going round that people will be dealt with before he's been exonerated. But now, if this trend continues, where it is a clear case of Iberiberism that he cannot patronize his own, people might begin to consider him as someone who is really, really Iberiberized. So it is a note of warning for Ihedioha. It is still early in the time to retrace your steps, make sure these things stop happening. Let us invest locally. Let us make these things work, not just taking state money, you know, and go to America to buy trucks or buy cars. If we decide, even if it means only in the southeast, that all the government cars that we give at least 50% to Innoson, Innoson will locally create jobs, expand. He can build factories in Imo State. He can expand to Abia. He can expand to Ebonyi. Why would every other person be buying from Innoson but those that ought to be his brother's keeper and buying from him? It doesn't make sense. The only thing that we can think, maybe the reason why this is happening, is, as I said before, it could be as a result of fraud, that they want to use the opportunity to launder money. Because if not, it doesn't make sense. Okay? So there is no way Innoson wouldn't be cheaper, and there is no way he cannot give me a better condition, because I don't think Innoson would be so stupid that if you walk up to him and say, we want to buy 50 of these vehicles, Ford is giving us these conditions, this warranty, and let's say for argument's sake, one is 10 million. And he said, okay, can you give us a discount? There's no way you wouldn't get that car for like 7.5, 8 million, you know, if genuinely, because that's the key word here, is genuine. If genuinely the person wants to work for the interests of the state, and if really the person is so convinced that he is working for the people, there is no reason why that person shouldn't patronize where it will be cheaper. You will create job. You know, if anything happens, because these are things that ought to be in a contract where you can say, if anything happens, you're going to give us 3-year contract, full service and maintenance, build it into the contract, and you deliver these vehicles, then you create job. Now you can go further and say, if you build a factory in Imo, for instance, we would give you tax incentives, and we employ Imo people, then we can sign an agreement with you that 30 to 50% of every government car that will be bought in Imo will be bought from your factory. That is a way you grow the economy. This is common sense, okay? So it is a time that we have to start thinking. You know, now 109 senators, we read, are going to be buying SUVs. And according to report, I think one of the SUVs, there's the Prado, brand new Prado, is about 50 million. Now, check that. All the National Assembly are going to get that. If we really want to grow this economy, let them go to Innoson and say, okay, let Innoson give them his G-Wagon, one of his best G-Wagon. I think that G-Wagon is about between 28 to 32 million. Let us begin. I mean, sometimes, honestly, I think the black man is apparently his greatest enemy. But we pray and we hope that Emeka Ihedioha will come out to address the people and to address this issue. Why is he not sourcing these vehicles for the police? Why is he not sourcing it locally? Why must he go to America if there is no underpinning corruption that you know, that drives him to go to America rather than buy it locally. This is Njenje Media Channel. Please subscribe to the channel. We'll be bringing you more analysis like this. Remain blessed.